Hello, how are you doing today, sir? Pretty well, pretty well. My name is Skylar Garza, and this is Jaime Hernandez, and we're promoting civics for y'all. Two bills are going to be heard in the state Congress today, House Bill 2008, House Bill 2009. Hi, how are y'all doing today? It's a legislative lobbying and policy, legislative process and lobbying and policy class.
We are here at the Capitol to talk to offices to ask them to support HB 3008 and 3009.
This is really the first time we've really been this heavily engaged in actually going out into the Capitol and lobbying, advocating, learning how the process works by doing it.
So I had a group of students who came and were really passionate about putting civics back into our public school curriculum.
We came up with sort of a joint effort to draft legislation on civics education projects.
So our bill requires that students get project-based civics education twice in their educational career, once in middle school and once in high school. And they'll learn how their government works, they'll learn how to advocate for issues they care about, and then they'll put that into practice by finding an issue in the community that they want to focus on.
I was really excited to hear that this bill is about civics education, because that's like what we're doing as part of the class, is we're getting this learning through this project through the whole semester, and then we're advocating for middle school and high school students to get the same type of experience that we're getting.
And we're like, what would be a good idea? Well, we're Texan, we're from Texas, what would be good? Y'all, what did Texans say? Y'all, so civics for y'all, because everyone needs civics. We feel that everyone could benefit from this kind of education in their lives, and it can help them in the future achieve what they want to achieve.
I think in this building, Republicans and Democrats agree that the greatest threat to our democracy is not each other. The greatest threat to our democracy is apathy, this corrosive indifference to civic life. And that apathy is demonstrated in the fact that our state has some of the worst civic health indicators in the entire country. We have incredibly low voter turnout. We have a low percentage of folks who volunteer in the community or who advocate here at the Capitol. And that's a real danger to the democratic process.
And we're here pushing on the civics education bill.
And I see it as a big experiment on our part to give students a chance to apply what they're learning in the class. And it's working.
Well, thanks. Yeah, y'all have a great lunch,
though. Right, hopefully.